Hello. I just, that thing, strike while the iron's hot. So that's what I'm doing. I'm striking while the iron's hot. The first thing I want to say, though, is thank you to all the new subscribers who have come on. I've seen a couple of new names and new anonymous things as well come from YouTube saying that the Girl on Duck channel has some new subscribers. So that's always lovely and always super, super encouraging. And some of you have been also speaking to me over on Instagram. So that's just lovely. I'm really thrilled. So thank you so much. So I have just come out of office hours in the Duck Pond, which is our monthly live coaching call that we do in Zoom. And there was lots of chatter and lots of talk because it's picture book month in the Duck Pond. So that's a particularly sort of a special month for us all. And but what I wanted to share here on the YouTubes that I thought might have been helpful to you guys, if you're not, in the Duck Pond or anything like that. There is something I want to share with you, right? So this morning, one of our members before office hours posted a really beautiful image in the Facebook group in the Duck Pond saying that images like this one always inspire me and always give me ideas. And she was just checking out the others to see if they experienced the same sort of thing. And then that reminded me. See, it worked, didn't it? It inspired me. It reminded me that in my book, See Me Jump, 20 Things I've Learned About Writing Books for Children, there's a section about that, of the 20 things. That's one of the things. It's about images and surrounding yourself with ideas and images. This morning we talked about Sandy Beach, and one of our members won a copy of I Want My Hat Back. And we were talking about this beautiful rendition of The Secret Garden, which is now available, in a gorgeous, gorgeous picture book format. It's been a retelling, obviously. We did a reading from the Goddess Love Oracle, which was really special. And the images in that are really, really beautiful. This whole idea of embracing your creativity and embracing your imagination and not compartmentalizing your life, but letting your whole life be an expression of creativity, an expression of your imagination, is where the juice is. So I thought, and so this morning in office hours, I read this section from the book because I wanted to remind people about it. Now, the book is available on Amazon. I don't know what the cover is at the moment. It's not this one. This is an old cover. I can't find the current one, honestly. It's somewhere. I know I've got a stack of them somewhere. Obviously, they're all together because I can't find any of them. But it's the title that you need, isn't it? See Me Jump by Jen Storer. So if you wanted to grab this book, it's on Amazon. But either way, actually, there's a whole spiel on this YouTube channel about it too. There's a whole section. Just dedicated to this book, a whole lot of videos. But I wanted to reread this section because I'm impressed myself, actually, because it's a really, really nice thing. All right, let me read it to you today. Tip number 18 is immerse yourself in words and pictures every day. It's everywhere, the nuts and bolts info about how to write picture books, the do's and don'ts. The lengthy explanations of rhyme, rhythm, repetition, etc. All you have to do is hit Google and you've got it. But what's always overlooked is the role that intuition plays in storytelling. I'm constantly encouraging aspiring authors to hone their intuition by immersing themselves in words and pictures. Don't overlook the endless opportunities you have every day to drink in stories and expand your imagination. Coffee table books, magazines, movies, picture books, Pinterest, Instagram, all these gifts fuel our imagination and enhance our visual literacy if you let them. As a creator, you must constantly invite inspiration into your life and into your subconscious. Pay close attention to what you're feeding your mind and soul. If you feel compelled to watch a film over and over, then you should do so. I always encourage creators to follow these urges. You might not understand why you're drawn to something, why you want to experience it over and over, but your inner artist knows. Plaster your workspace with words and images that delight you. Keep refreshing them too. Cut out poems and place them in frames. Listen to audiobooks while you're doing the housework or gardening. Make words and pictures essential to your life as running errands and shopping. Consciously and deliberately immerse yourself in words and pictures every day. Live your life in a way that constantly makes space for inspiration. Resist the urge to compartmentalize your life. Let creativity and inspiration spill into every corner of your day. Let it be your constant companion. Let the beautiful, exciting, intriguing work of others help you develop an intuitive gift for creating worlds and storytelling. We are all born storytellers. It's just that some of us have forgotten. We've been looking in the wrong direction, distracted by the mundane, when all along there was beauty and inspiration everywhere. And that's from See Me Jump. 20 things I've learned about writing books for children. I have to look at the title all the time to remember the title because it's a bit of a mouthful. And it does talk about picture books near the end, but the entire book is not just about picture books. It covers creative writing in general. So if you're writing middle grade, indeed, if you're writing for adults, you will benefit from this book as well, because the tips are really succinct. And as we always say, writing is writing is writing. Okay. So that's what I wanted to share with you this morning. Just a really quick little shot of inspiration, a little inspo bomb coming to you directly from Girl and Duck on this. What is it today? Doesn't matter because you could watch this any day. You might be watching it 2 years from now. Thursday, the 4th of April, 2024. All right. I'll see you again soon. Thanks for subscribing and thanks for the likes. Like, totally, totally thank you. Okay, bye.